Hi, it's Janie. Welcome back to my channel. Wow. Hope everyone had a Merry Christmas. I did. Enjoyed it, spending it with the grandkids and the kids and watching them open their presents and just had a really good day. And today I'm filming my last haul of 2019. I have a few items that were sent to me, and then I have a couple items that, well, it's just one item that my daughter gave me, and then I have my Sephora haul where I use my $25 off $75 promotion that was for VIB Rouge and I think VIBs. Anyway, I figured this is my last year to be VIB Rouge because I wasn't going to use it. I thought it was my last year to be VIB Rouge, and I also had a credit where I had returned some stuff, so I thought, well, I'm going to use it. Anyway, so I'm going to start with the two items that I have that are PR, and I also have a little bit of surprise with those PR items, so if you don't like PR and you're going to skip through those, you may not want to because there's going to be a little surprise. So anyway, the first thing I want to start with is this product here from Sawasu. Anyway, it is a Korean brand. This is one of the higher end Korean brands, kind of the luxury side of Korean brand. Anyway, this was sent to me for review through Ulta, and Sawasu did send this to me. I was surprised that they selected me because sometimes I apply to this brand and they don't always select me. Shame on them. Gosh, how rude. Anyway, this is the Perfecting Cushion Intense, and it has a broad spectrum SPF 50 sunscreen, and it is the number 13, which they say is a light pink. Anyway, it is a cushion, but it's very luxurious. I mean, first of all, you gotta love the packaging, which is this dark chocolate with the gold packaging. Outstanding. It has a lot of skincare properties in it. And I'm going to kind of let you know about that. And I never realized that Sawasu was also produced by the company Amore Pacific. Did y'all know that? I don't think I really realized that. But anyway, I'm going to pull up this app. I should have already had this done. Here it is. It has a lot of skincare benefits in it, this cushion does. It's got the precious red pine extract in it, which is for anti-aging benefits for firmer looking skin, which of course is going to be over time. It has plum blossom extract to help your skin look healthy and youthful. It also has Radiance Pearl Powder Complex, helps provide your skin a bright and radiant glow. That it does, especially if you can go without putting powder on it. It definitely has a really pretty, radiant, glowy skin to it. But I have to powder because if I could go without powdering, and if I could use like cream products like a cream bronzer and a cream blush and a cream highlight, oh, that would be so pretty, but I just can't do it. But I am wearing this. I am wearing this today. I've had it on since 10 o'clock this morning, 10:30 this morning, and it's about 5. No, yeah, about 5 o'clock. And this is actually Christmas Day that I'm filming this. We just got home. And, there's like, the shade range is not that great. There's only 7 shades. Anyway, it has pink undertones and also yellow undertones to choose from. And you can do a moderate amount, and then you can also put more on to do extra coverage. I have found that when you do try to do extra coverage, it takes a really long time for it to dry. So I don't recommend that. I just recommend doing a thin layer. So if you're someone that doesn't like a heavy foundation, I mean, definitely this is not a foundation, it's a cushion, and it's a very light cushion, very, very light cushion. So if you like something that's very, very lightweight, you would definitely like this. Yeah, embedded with microfibers, it's unique micro brush, has a brushing effect that gently and evenly provides coverage for signs of wrinkles and fine lines. I haven't used the little puff for cushion sponge, that's what I'm trying to say. I use my beauty blender for it anyway. But it does not last. I say the longevity of it is maximum 3 to 4 hours. And that's with the powder. I couldn't imagine what it would be without a powder. But anyway, here's the little cushion, little sponge that comes with it. And then it has this little ribbon here that you're supposed to put over your fingers. And then, of course, you know, they want you to kind of just, you know, roll it and press it into the skin. I haven't tried that. In the past, when I've done cushions and they have these, I don't have good luck with these, so I didn't even try that. Anyway, here's the actual packaging of it. Look how pretty that is. It's just so pretty. And it's just your typical cushion. The actual cushion part of it, this part, this case here, was empty. And the cushions themselves came in little packs. I'll show you what those look like here in just a minute. And then you unwrap them. I take that back. This one was already in here. It was sealed with a foil over the top. And then you just open it, and you're supposed to put this in here and then puff it onto your face. Press it. I just use my beauty blender. But anyway, there it is. When it starts getting dry on top, you can take your tweezers, lift this cushion out, and flip it over, and you've got more product on top. Anyway, and then of course it has a little mirror there. And it comes with a backup cushion in there, so you get two of them in there. So when that one's done, you have Oh, there's a little booklet in here too that probably tells about everything that I just told you as far as the properties. And of course, it's all going to be in different languages. Yeah. So, anyway, there will be a link in the description box for the product. That is the only stipulation that is required of me, is one, that I do the review of it, whether it's good or bad, and that the link is in the box, or in the description box. And the little, this right here fits right there, is how that's supposed to go. So there you go, there's that. And like I said, you know, this brand is on the luxury side of the skin, you know, the Korean skincare line, or the Korean brands, and this will is $80. Yeah, so I'm glad it was sent to me for review. Would I purchase it once this is done? No, because I don't like, I think the finish of it is pretty, but I don't think it's long lasting, and I don't like, I'm trying to fluff my hair. I've got my mirror here, and I see that my hair needs to be fluffed. Anyway, I'm not one that wants to touch up throughout the day as far as my face makeup goes. So this would not work. It's not going to work for me. I mean, I'm going to use it, but I wouldn't purchase it on its own. So, but then again, I may, after I've used it in its entirety, I may find that I really, really like it. But anyway, so there's that. Dang, that was like almost a 10-minute review on that one. So we're going to go to the next product. And this product, I was so excited when this popped up. And I thought, I am going to apply for that. Even though I don't like to apply for these types of products. Because 9 times out of 10, whenever something like this is sent to me, I don't really like it. Because I'm very, very picky about perfumes, colognes, scents. And most of the time, I don't like them. And but this one, I had to select it. I had to try to get selected for it. And so again, this was sent to me through Octoly. And this was from the brand Scent Beauty, which is right there. And the reason why I wanted to do it is because supposedly this is a perfume that this lady right here is supposed to have created, Cher. So who doesn't want to smell like Cher? I mean, this lady right here, at however old she is, 70, and she's in her 70s, and it is still rocking it. I mean, come on now. Who doesn't want to smell like that? I mean, come on now. So, I applied for it, you know, what has it been, 2 years ago? Going on 3 years ago, my husband and I, we went to one of her shows in Vegas, and it was just outstanding. That's where I got this program book. So anyway, so here is the packaging, and here is how it was presented from this company. And love your scent, love yourself, from Scent Beauty. To love oneself is the beginning of a lifelong romance, and this was said by Oscar Wilde. And it is the box here. It says Cher Eau de Couture. It's made in the U.S. and it's from the ScentBeauty.com. Is the company that has made this. Now, I really don't know if she really had anything to do with this. I don't know. I don't know that for sure. But anyway, the presentation was really nice. It's a 1.7 fluid ounce bottle. And you slide it up like this. And here is the bottle. And it's very, very Cher, I think, as far as the packaging. Because, you know, it's got, like, looks like leather kind of around it. Kind of edgy. And then it says Cher, where you can see it through the bottle where it says Cher through there. So I would assume that they would have had to have had her permission to name it Cher. So that is the box that it came in. Very nice. Very, very nice. So let me read you what the notes are in it and what it says about it. And this bottle is $85 for this perfume. It says, a scent as sexy and iconic as its inspiration. And it has vibrant notes of bergamot and neroli meet the intimate florals of jasmine and rose. So, of course, that's one of the reasons why I wanted it, too, is because it's supposed to have rose in it. And smoke and spice of sandalwood and clove. And it says, and this is a supposedly quote from Cher, I made it for people who love perfume and want to smell good, and for people who feel that it's part of who they are, Cher. So, top notes are bergamot, clove, neroli. Middle notes, jasmine, rose, orange flower. Base notes, sandalwood, velveteer, vanilla, orchid. That is what it smells like. I've worn it just a couple times. I haven't had it for just a few days. I'm not crazy about the scent myself. And I can't pinpoint what it is. It doesn't say that it has musk in it, but it almost has a hint of musk. And I like musk. I really do. But I kind of get like a powdery scent to it. And there's nothing wrong with a powdery scent. but I was really expecting more warmth to it. I was expecting more warmth, a little bit more spiciness to it than more, it's more feminine than what I thought it was going to be, because I really thought it was going to be a little bit more edgy than what I was expecting. Not that it smells bad, because it doesn't. It doesn't smell bad, it's just not what I was expecting it to be. And it's not really quite what I like personally. But still, it was created by Cher. So, anyway. So the surprise is that for whatever reason, they sent me two bottles. I got another shipment, and I tried to contact them, this company, and was not able to contact them, and so I'm going to do it in a giveaway. So, just let me know in the comments in the description box, if you're familiar with Cher, what your favorite Cher song is. I do believe that my favorite song is, and my husband and I both were so excited when she actually had it in the show, because we didn't know if she would, but she did. She had it in the show, and of course wore the iconic costume that went with the song. And I'm gonna see if it's in this book. I can't remember if it was in the book. Oh yeah, here it is. Here's the picture of it right here. This right here, and that is the song Half Breed. Yes, that is my favorite song, and she did have it in her show, and it was wonderful. So anyway, so let me know in the comments below what your favorite Cher song is, and if you're not a Cher fan, that's okay. Just let me know what your favorite song is. There you go. Okay, so that is it for the PR products. Oh my stars, and we're like 17 minutes into the video. Holy cow. Okay, so now the product that my daughter gave to me that she got in one of her subscription boxes. I don't know which one it is that she gets. I can never remember, but she gets some good stuff that she doesn't like that she gives to me, and one of them was from Natasha Denona, and it's the Bloom Blush and Glow palette that I have been thinking about getting, but it has in it those cream products, and I don't like cream products, so I didn't want to just buy it for the two blush products that are in here. So she got it, and of course these colors are way too dark for her because she's very, very fair-complected. So she gave them to me, and I gladly accepted them and have been wearing these two colors right here. This one here is more of like a highlight or a blush topper, but this one right here is just a beautiful, beautiful blush. And I should have wore it today, but today, I don't know where you guys live, but here in Oklahoma, it was like 70 degrees today on Christmas Day, which was perfect because the grandkids got a trampoline for Santa, brought them a trampoline. So, anyway, very, very pretty. And then these other two products here are cream. They're supposed to be cream blushes. There's no way, especially this color right here, there's no way I would be able to wear that as a blush, a cream blush. I would have that as a mess, but you know what I've been wearing it as a lipstick of the morning. It doesn't last very long as a lipstick, but that's what I've been wearing it as. Now this color right here, I might be able to maybe one day get brave and use it as a cream blush, but anyway, there they are swatched. So, they're pretty. So I was like, heck yeah, I'll take that. She's like, do you want this from Natasha Denona? I'm like, yeah, I'll take it. So she gave me that. So that was for my daughter. And now I need to get a makeup wipe, and we'll get into the Sephora stuff. Okay. Okay, now we're going to get into the Sephora stuff that I ordered. And this, like I said, was with my $25 off $75. And then I already had some credits, so I ended up only spending, I think it was like $14, $15. Out of pocket. So, the first thing I got was this little kit here from Milk Cosmetics. I was going to get this during the 20% off sale, and I talked myself out of it. But it was still available, so I got it. Anyway, it came with the full-size Kush mascara, which I really, really do like. And I've only been had the little baby ones, the little deluxe size samples. And this one had the full size plus some little freebies or little sample stuff that came with it. And so I really like this mascara. It actually is what I used today for my mascara. And then the freebies was a eyebrow gel, which I did use and liked it, so I didn't have any problems with that. And I forget half the time to use anything like this, so this will last me a long time because I forget most of the time. And then it came with a little lip balm, so that will last me a long time too. A little lip balm, so came with that. So that was a good find. And then I also ordered, because I've been wanting to try this, the Summer Fridays Jet Lag Mask. And this was just like one of those minis. It's not the full size, but I've been wanting to try this for a long time. That jet lag mask. And it's like a rinse off mask. It's right here. So I got one of those to try. This will last quite a bit of time. It's like a cream. Let's see. It smells okay. It's not too heavily scented. Not so much the smell, it kind of has like a cooling effect. It kind of feels good, but yeah. So, we'll see how refreshed it makes my skin look after using it. Then, I ordered a couple of eyeshadow products from two brands that I don't have anything of, so that I wanted to try. And one of them is from Pat McGrath. So I've opened it and I've already got these little secret. I wish you would just do away with these sequin things. It's just a waste. That is just a waste. Let me see. Quit doing that. Anyway, these, I've heard a lot of people talk about how this is just a good way to just kind of try the brand. It's no fancy packaging. It's just some little eyeshadows. But it was inexpensive for her eyeshadows. Because her eyeshadows are expensive. But then so is Natasha Denona. Natasha Denona. Gosh, why can't I say that? So anyway, I debated, there was another one that had like some purples and some teals, and I debated between the two. But I went ahead and got this one because it has like a matte brown, which is right here. And I thought, well, this one I could probably have the best luck with creating an eye look with this one. Should have got that other one. Blue. unswatched. I was like, that color is a lot darker than what I thought it was going to be. Ooh. So anyway, so now I can kind of see what all the fuss is about with that. So I have that to try. And then the other one that I got is the one that I am wearing today that I put on. And that is from the brand Huda. I put it back in this box the wrong way. But anyway, this is from Huda. I don't have anything from this brand. And I heard a lot of people talk about it. And I debated on these and then the other little small ones that she has. But I ended up getting this one. This is the Nude Light from Huda Beauty. What matches my pink shirt that I have on. And this is the light. And I couldn't make up my mind if I wanted the light, the medium, or the dark. And I went and got the light, and I'm really glad I did. This turned out really, really pretty. I get it open, and that is what it looks like. And I used, let's see, what color did I not use today? I did not use this color here as far as the mattes go. And the shimmer shade that I have on is this one here. I just thought this was really, really pretty. I thought all three of them were pretty. And I may end up getting the other two at some point because I really liked the way that it worked this morning. It was really easy to work with. So here's some of the swatches. Yeah, I thought it was real easy to work with. Really pretty pinks. Easy to work with pinks. You know, sometimes you get pinks and they're almost too much on the red side and they don't look good. Or at least I think these look good. You guys may not think so. Oops, I already swatched that one. Thought that was really, really pretty. And she had another palette that was kind of bigger than this that's been out for a while that had a lot of these colors that I always thought was really pretty, but I just never bought it. So I kind of have something similar to that. So anyway, and then the two samples I got was this perfume from Valentino Donna. Genist eye renewal balm. So that was it. So that is it. That is the last of my haul. The last of my hauls. That's the last haul for 2019. So anyway, I hope that you have enjoyed. I hope that you had a Merry Christmas. And if this happens to be my last video for 2019, I don't think it will be. I'm thinking my empties for 2019 for December will be my last video, but just in case something happens. Anyway, if this ends up being my last video that you see before January gets here, I hope you have a happy new year and be safe. Anyway, hope you enjoyed and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.